If you've ever road tripped across the United States, chances are you saw a lot of power lines. And in a new high renewable energy future, you might see even more. That's because it's going to take a lot more wind and solar to decarbonize, and a lot more transmission to deliver all that electricity from the windiest and sunniest regions to where people live. To increase transmission capacity, we can increase the number of transmission lines, increase how much power the lines can carry, or both. Like any long-lived infrastructure, it will take some careful planning to figure out the right combination of options to maximize transmission, both old and new. Option one is to change the way we operate transmission using dynamic line ratings. A line rating is the maximum amount of electricity that a transmission line can safely carry. Think of it like the maximum speed a driver can go. Grid operators often set a conservative line rating based on the worst-case conditions for the transmission system. Super hot days when conductors can overheat and cause the wires to sag, touch trees, and cause fires. But just as traffic conditions can vary, so can the weather conditions that affect transmission lines. On cold and windy days, the wires can safely handle more power. Dynamic line ratings are like adjustments to driving speeds based on road conditions. Just as drivers slow down in snowy or icy weather and speed up in dry or sunny weather, system operators use dynamic line ratings to adjust transmission capacity based on real-time factors like temperature and wind speed. Dynamic line ratings enable more power on transmission lines when conditions allow, without compromising safety. Option two is to retrofit existing transmission or build new transmission with devices called flexible alternating current transmission systems, or FACTS. Almost all power lines use alternating current, or AC, which has historically been the most cost-effective way of generating and transmitting electricity. But grid operators can't actually tell electricity where to go on AC power lines. That means even if we build a big transmission line, electricity might still travel on small, overloaded lines. It's like a driver that doesn't use a navigation app and takes inefficient routes. FACTS are the navigation apps of transmission. These hardware devices attach to new or existing transmission and monitor and analyze power flow in real time to steer electricity to the lines that are underutilized. Both FACTS and navigation apps continuously assess the changing conditions to optimize the flow of traffic or power. Option three is to build new higher voltage AC lines. Higher voltage lines are like superhighways that can carry a lot more electricity than lower voltage lines. A line with double the voltage can carry four times the amount of power. In some cases, existing AC lines can be retrofitted to be higher voltage. Option four is to use high voltage direct current lines, or HVDC lines. HVDC lines have several benefits over AC lines. First, the flow of electricity on HVDC lines can be controlled, which increases the utilization of the lines. HVDC lines use additional hardware called converter stations that convert DC electricity back into AC to be used on the grid. These converter stations are also what allow the flow of electricity to be controlled. Second, HVDC lines are more cost-effective at transmitting electricity very long distances. It's normal to lose some electricity when transmitting at long distances, but HVDC lines lose less compared to AC lines. Third, because an HVDC line has two wires compared to three on AC lines, it has a smaller footprint while carrying the same amount of electricity. Right now, there are only 5 HVDC lines in the U.S. As more wind energy is deployed in remote locations, we'll most likely have to build some more lines, and HVDC lines are an effective and efficient option. The bottom line: building our clean energy systems of the future will require more transmission capacity to move low-cost renewable electricity into population centers. With careful planning and a combination of transmission options, the U.S. can optimize the use of existing lines and help reduce some of the need to build new lines, cruising to our clean energy destination faster and cheaper.